Singapore has seen a series of train disruptions in September and October this year. But we should not generalize the cause of these disruptions. I'm Associate Professor Raymond Ong from the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering at the National University of Singapore. We have seen a series of rail disruptions from September to October 2024, and these include disruptions along the Circle Line, and in particular, the 6-day disruption along the East-West Line, and also we have seen disruptions along the Thomson East Coast Line, which is a relatively new line that was constructed and opened recently. It will be too simplified to generalize that the rail disruptions are getting more common. We have to take the context of a measure of performance, which we typically use the term mean kilometers before failure. It actually means the distance the train has covered before we see a failure or a disruption that lasts 5 minutes or more. Prior to these incidents, we are looking at the mean kilometers before failure of at least 1 to 2 million kilometers. And this is way above international standards. The most common reason for train disruptions are mainly signal faults and the power faults. So for signal faults, usually it is due to power or signal coordination, whereby the train would not be able to ascertain whether they are to go or not to go. So if there is some issues with the signal, the trains would not be able to behave autonomously like what it should be doing. And for the power faults, usually we'll be talking about issues such as power trips, power failure, which results in the third rail not having power to drive the train forward. And this obviously will lead to disruption. The recent MRT breakdowns highlight whether an aging rail infrastructures is the main cause of the disruption. But we have to take into context on two parts. The first part is on the train part, and the second part is on the rail infrastructure part. On the train part, all the trains have to be maintained to a certain standard or protocol before they are allowed to move on the track. And this is regardless whether it is a 1-year-old train or a 35-year-old train. They have to meet the same standards. Now, on the infrastructure parts, the railway tracks, the signals, the third rails, they are also subjected to the same kind of standards and protocols, whereby the operators, they are actually doing daily maintenance and monitoring using various devices to check whether there are defects in the system. However, one may have a perception that a new line should not have any disruption. But I have to say that this is not entirely true. We have to understand that every line has their own unique systems and technology in terms of the railway, in terms of the communications, in terms of the signal systems. We can see that there could be teething issues due to perhaps signal faults. And these would provide learning lessons on how to improve the algorithms and the systems that's been put in place in the field for operations.